Hey, this is John, Happy Wife Acres. I'm out in the shop again. What I'm about to show you, I didn't come up with, but it was so cool, I just have to share it with you. We're gonna show you how to fool a smart battery charger. So if you're a homesteader, you probably have a lot of equipment that has batteries in it. Maybe a tractor, UTV, lawnmower, motorcycle, and especially a car. If you're not using those things every day, the battery might run down, or maybe you left the lights on. So if you're a good homesteader, you've got a battery charger. Even if you just own a car, get one of these. Next time your car dies, you don't have to call anybody. So this battery charger is great. It's a 12 volt battery charger. I've had it since dinosaurs roamed the earth back in the 80s sometime. It does one thing. It charges. You plug it in and out comes electricity. Hook it up to the battery. But a couple of years ago, I needed a 6 volt battery charger. So I bought this. This is what most battery chargers are today. It's a smart charger. What does that mean? Well, the designers think you're not smart enough to operate a battery charger, so they put in stuff for you. One is, if you hook it up wrong, reverse the polarity, it'll tell you about that, and it'll recondition the battery. It'll start out charging a lot, then it slows down. But one of the features that's built in is if your battery is dead, it won't work. You have to have at least 3 volts on your battery. So I was getting very frustrated with this thing because I knew my battery was good because I used it last summer. Just turned the mower off. I didn't use it. It drained out. Now I just want it charged up so I can go mow the grass. Hook it up and this thing just starts giving you zeros across the display. I'm not knocking this particular one. They're all like this. It's not a huge deal if this one isn't working well for me on a dead battery. I'm just going to go grab this one if it's for the car or 12 volt battery. But I've got a couple of things that are 6 volts, like the tractor. And when that dies, I can't use this. This won't work, so I'm kind of screwed. Here's what I found out. You can easily make a device that will charge it up to 3 volts. This is a power supply. You probably got a drawer full of them. This is a 6 volt, and it puts out 0.6 amp. I cut off the piece that was on here and put on a couple of clips. You can buy clips at Harbor Freight or your local hardware store. So I just stripped the wire, put these on, and marked them red and black. You can use your multimeter to find out which one's positive, which one's negative. But in this case, it was the black wire with the gray stripe on it. You can use your multimeter to check it out. This is actually putting out 9.88 volts. That's okay, it's such a low amperage. We just want to get the battery above 3 volts. Sorry for the noise, but it's lay time. Just hook this up to your battery, plug in the charger, and let it stay that way for about 30 minutes. 30 minutes later, unplug it, and check the voltage on your battery. If it's above 3 volts, you're good to go. Hook up your smart charger and plug it in, and it'll start charging. The same technique is going to work for 12 volt battery, 6 volt battery. If you want something with a little higher voltage, find another power supply. This one does 13 volts. It could be 10 volts, 9 volts. Just something that will get the battery up to 3 volts and make this stupid smart charger start working.
So if you're having troubles with your smart battery charger because it thinks it's smarter than you are, outsmart it. Modify something you probably already have, so this thing can get going again. Thanks for watching. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button and hit that bell so you'll be notified of new videos. And we will see you soon on the homestead. Bye.